Okay, welcome to Exit 45 Restorations. For those of you who've been with this channel for a while now, you know that this is not my normal video. I'm going to do a how-to, just show you, basically show, bring you along with some of the maintenance I'm doing on my truck. Got some problems with the shifting in the transmission, so while I'm in there, I'm going to change out all the sensors. So I'm going to do the pressure sensor transducer on this one. Okay, so we'll just try to keep each video with each sensor that I'm doing. It'll be easier for people to do the search and find the video for what they're trying to get done. So let's get at it. Let's get that changed out. Okay, so up underneath the truck, you can see I've got the truck jacked up and secured in multiple ways. I even still have the jack up underneath it, so it's pretty secure. So let's press on. All right, so the first thing I need to do is I need to get the pan off. So what I'm gonna do is pull all the bolts except for two on either side, and then I will just loosen up one side and then start to remove the other side and let that pan slowly angle down and control the fluid coming out of it so I don't have a big mess. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the bolts out. And when I get ready to start loosening it up to do the final loosening so it'll drain, I will bring you back in, because I don't have room underneath here for the camera. It doesn't want to work under here. All right, so let me get that done. All right, guys, so I've got just the two bolts here and the two bolts on this side. All right, that was tight, a little too tight, but all right, so well, fun begins. We gotta get this to break loose. There it goes. All right, let's just let it drain. Okay. So it looks like the excess is drained out. Now, we gotta try and get a little bit more out of this pan before I can. There we go. Messy. I got most of it though. Not all of it, but I got most of it. All right, guys, so got some gloves on in an attempt to keep this clean as much as possible. We don't need anything dirt-wise trying to, so we're gonna try and keep it as clean as we can. So next step, we gotta get this filter off so we can get to all the different areas that we need to get to. All right, so let's get that. I don't know, it looks like some kind of Torx bit or something like that. There it is. All right. All righty, there's one. Tried not to drop that in there, but I did it anyways. Okay, so let's go ahead and get the governor pressure solenoid out of here. Looks like we've got four bolts holding this on, so let's go ahead and get those out. Actually, it's just these three on this side. This one here doesn't go to that. Okay, there's the three bolts. There's two Torx bits on either side here that have to come out as well. We'll figure it out together, all right, guys? All right, there it is. We just got to get the connector loose and this bracket just comes off. Set that aside. Okay, now that we got the governor pressure solenoid out of the way, now we need to get this out of the way. So we just got one more bolt to take out and a electrical connector here. Let's get this last bolt. Okay. All right, there's that. Need to get this undone. You know, this light just, there it went. All right, so the tab, the red tab just pulls back and that should release the, should release it. There it goes. All right, now we can get this out of the way. Okay, so this plate, before we go back on with this plate, my kit came with a new plug here, so we'll just go ahead and pull that, and we'll put the new one on. There we go. And we got the new one on. It also came with a new gasket. All right, then we got our new gasket. That'll go on just like that. Okay, so now we need to install the housing underneath here. Right here, and you can see I got a new gasket for it. And so what we just need to do is line up, figure out where our holes go. Looks like we're gonna go this way. And we're gonna go on like this. All right, so we're gonna go on like this. I just gotta get the bolts and get them all started so we can get this going. I am keeping you out of there. All right, so you can see it right here. And we just need 1, 2, 3. Looks like maybe, you know, there's a maybe one there. Looks like 3. So just the 3 bolts. All right, and then these 2 Torx bolts here. All right, so let me get that in. All right, so what I got now is I got governor pressure solenoid set in the bracket, and we can now put this bracket up into the transmission. All right, and that is gonna go right here. All right, so it's gonna go right here, and then there's the plug that plugs into it. So let me get this all bolted up in there, and then I will show you when I get that done. All right, got this all in. Bolts are all in. I know it's hard to see around here. My light doesn't show back there, but they're all in, all around here. And now we just need to hook up our plug. And get this plugged in. And we're bolted in. So we're pretty much ready at this point to put the filter on and put the pan back on. All right, so I've got the drain plug in. There you go, right there. And the magnet is in here, the pan's clean. And we got a gasket. So filter's on. So let's get this up and we can wrap this up. Okay, so I've got the pan in, it's all snugged up, and I got my nice little drain plug there, so the next time I do my fluid, it's going to be much easier. So we're all good. I got everything buttoned up. Now we just gotta add some fluid and then test it out. Okay guys, so I'm pretty much finished underneath the car. See if we can't get some transmission fluid in, take this thing for a drive and see how she does. All right, so got done with the sensor replacement and it's all put back together. So why don't we see if we can't take it out and see how it does. see what we get. Got an engine light. Not sure why I've got that. That wasn't there before, so that don't look good. Alright, let's get it out here and Alright, so we got a good shift there and a good shift there. I may have to clear a code in there. So one of the things that happened here while I was, I went to check this out a little bit earlier today, and the it didn't want to shift properly, and the engine light came on. So I unplugged the overdrive sensor and found that it had a bent pin in it. So I had to buy a new one and get it replaced. So that's probably why that light is on, because it wasn't getting the right signal. It seems to be doing just fine. So I'll probably clear that code, but yeah, I mean, you can see it, watch it. There it goes, there's a shift. There's the other one. All right. Well, guys, looks like we got it. I like it. It hasn't shifted that good in a while. It's been shifting kind of odd. All right, guys. So we're going to wrap this up. I'm bringing it back home now. Everything seems to be shifting pretty good right now for me. Everything seems to be good. So I hope this helps any of you guys out there who are looking to do this on your truck, or really whatever. This tranny's in several different vehicles, Durangos or whatever. And really all the other trannies, they're all about the same. So I hope it helps, guys. So I'll catch you on the next, little piece of maintenance I do on this truck or car or whatever. Try and get it out there for you guys if you want to have another set of eyes and see what's going on or how it's done. All right, I appreciate it. Thank you, and see you on the next video.